Tokyo Electric Power has supplied the first look inside two of the reactor buildings at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. The video was shot on Sunday and Monday and shows the insides of Units 2 and 3. The primary video came from a pair of robots sent inside, and the video supplied to the media comes from a camera trained at a couple of laptops being used to control the robots. Unit 3 experienced a hydrogen explosion on March 14th, and the video shows debris strewn around the inside of the first floor. In this shot, what appears to be a ladder is mangled against electrical equipment. The robot makes a steady pace forward across debris, a task that's all the easier thanks to its caterpillar tracks. Bit by bit, it moves ahead. In some parts of the video, the robot can be seen using its long arm to open doors. One of the reasons these robots were chosen is because they can accomplish a range of tasks guided by remote operators. The robots measured the temperature, gases in the air, and radioactivity. In Unit 3, they measured radiation levels of up to 57 millisieverts per hour. That means a plant worker could spend just under 5 hours in this atmosphere before reaching the annual limit for radiation exposure. Inside Unit 2, the robots provided a different view. There doesn't appear to be any debris lying around, but the camera lens is foggy due to high humidity in the building. That's a product, Tokyo Electric suspects, of damage to the suppression pool that sits at the base of the structure. Here too, radiation levels were high, too high for workers to enter, and that's why the robots are being used. Sent from the United States, they're iRobot PackBots. Normally used by the military on bomb defusion missions, these robots are capable of a range of tasks in hazardous environments. Tokyo Electric has been battling to bring the stricken Fukushima nuclear power plant under control for almost 6 weeks. The video and data provided by the robots has given the company its first look inside the reactor buildings and adds another piece to the company's understanding of what happened at the plant and how it might bring it to a cold shutdown, something that's expected to take up to 9 months. In Tokyo, this is Martin Williams, IDG News Service.